Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to save your score. So go ahead and go into your player selection. This is where we unlock our players and then we select a particular player for our game. So I'm going to go ahead and get into my forest, which is my first stage, and then add my event. Okay, so I'm going to scroll downwards and then click on this link, which unlocks our player and also acts as a score notification. So I click the link here and then it sends me into this particular scene. So right here, I'm going to add an action variables. No, sorry, storage. Let's go to storage. Okay. Right here, we have read a value. So I'm going to read a value. My storage name is going to be carrot data. And then the group is going to be carrot count. So enter whatever name you want to use for storing your coins or your score. Okay, so we are saying we want our global variable, which is our score, our global variable score, to be stored in storage name carrot data and that of a group carrot count. So I'm going to go get into my variables over here and then select or click value of a global variable, and then the name is score. So if you don't have a global variable, do that, set your score to a global variable, and then that's it. So now I'm able to write my score into my carrot count and that of my carrot data. So I'll go into my player selection scene, and what I want to happen is I want to be able to display my score after I finish playing my forest right here as a high score. So anytime I play my stages and I have a particular score, it displays itself over here for me once I come to my player selection screen. So I'm going to do that. So add a text, say high score or score. In my case, I'm using high score, so it's the score you see every time. Okay, so this is going to be my score, which is the number itself. I'm going to drag it to my far right corner, and then I'm going to drag the text too, so I have my high score. So anytime I play my game, and either I'm able to complete and move on to the next stage, or I'm gamed totally and then I'm not able to move on to the next stage, that score will be stored in my carrot count and then it will be displayed here for me. So I'll have it displaying or showing over here that, oh, this is the score that I had in my previous game. So once I restart the game again and I play it again, a different score will be showed over here depending on how many carrots I took. So this is my high score, and then this is my score. Okay, so now let's set our storage, our group name and that of our storage name into this particular score. So I'm scrolling downwards and I'm going straight to unlock player selection. Okay, so this is where I check if my score is greater than my total. We tackled that in my previous video where it had to do with player unlocking. So if you've not seen it, I'll leave a link below. You can go and check it out and then use that in your game. If you are creating a game or just practicing something, you can just do it for fun. You can do it for your game, which probably you might release on Play Store, not or any other website. You have HIO. If you want to send it over there, you can send it over there too. Okay. Let me go back into my player selection event. Right on top here, go ahead and then add an event. Okay, so we say add a condition, and the condition is to check if truly what you've thought exists. So existence of a group and the name, storage name that we used, if you remember, was our carrot data. We are going to use that same name. Make sure you don't change it. If you change it, it's going to affect the game and then it's not going to work. So carrot data, and then the group is going to be our carrot count, and then I'll click on OK. So if it checks in my carrot count exists in storage carrot data, then what it's supposed to do is supposed to read whatever is in there. Going to read whatever is my storage. So we are going to read it as a value. So whatever is in my carrot data, and then whatever is in my carrot group, which is carrot count, you should go ahead and then store it in a scene variable named score. So if you don't have a scene variable, add a scene variable. If you don't know what a scene variable is, okay, if you, when you go to your screen here, which is your display screen, click right click and then click on scene properties, edit scene variables, and then you can just go ahead and then add, click here and then add your variable, your scene variable. Okay, so that's how to add a scene variable. So from here we are saying it has read the value of carrot count and then our carrot data, which is supposed to hold our global variable score, into score itself. So now we want it to display, want it to display as a text at our point of the high score. So I don't feel like typing, so I'm just going to copy and then paste. So I'll go into my forest event. Okay, right over here I have do to string of, so I'll copy that one and then I'll paste it right under my new event over here, which is under my player selection. So I have to string right here is global variable, so I'll go ahead and change it to a variable because we are storing it in our variable, text variable called score, and this text variable is the text over here, the name is called score. So we are storing whatever is in our value, our carrot count over here. So if it's 100 points, you're going to see 100 points here. If you said if it's 200 points, you're going to see 200. If it's 500, you're going to see 500. So that's what we are doing. We are picking it from our global score, which is our latest score, and then we are displaying it over here as our high score. So it's going to remind you, it's going to change every time you play the game. So if you played it the first time and you had 100, it's going to be stored as 100. So when you come here, you see 100. When you play it a second time, you're going to have a different score. If you had 50, you're going to see 50 as your new high score. So it's going to be changing. And we can set this high score to unlock our bunnies. So I have right here. Let me go ahead and run the game so you see if it's working. Let's check if it's working. So I run it. Okay, so I'll select my first player over here, which is Normal Bunny. And then I'm going to use him to play the game. So right now I have score of 30. Yeah, oh, it's game over, so my score is here. It's 30. So I'll go ahead and quit the game. If I should run it again, my high score is going to be set to 30. And that's what I was trying to say. Once you play the game, you have your score set up here at your right hand corner for you as the value that you scored in your previous game. So I have 30 as my high score. If I should replay it, that 30 is going to change depending on the score I scored in this new game. So let's say this one, oh, this one is also 30, so I'll still have 30. Let me restart it. Okay, so this is 50. If I should run it again, okay, so my new high score now is 50 instead of the 30. So your latest or your previous or your recent score is what is going to be displayed here. So I'm going to close it. And what we are going to look at next is we are going to use a score over here that we stored into our variable, our same variable score. We are going to use that to unlock these bunnies or players. If yours is, your character is different, yeah, you're going to use to unlock that one. So I'm going to go ahead, scroll downwards and click on a link that I have, which is unlock player selection right here. Okay, so right here, we say our score, we should check if our score is greater than or equal to variable score total. So how to get that done is you add a condition into our variables and then you click on value of a scene variable and check if the score in our scene variable is equal to the score of our scene variable total. So I have value of a scene variable and that scene variable is total. In my score total, click on OK. In my score total, let me go back to my player selection. Now right click over here and get into my scene properties. My score total is 100, so it's going to check if the score value in my score is also equal to 100. If it's equal to 100, what it's going to do is going to allow the player to be able to unlock the bunny over here. I'm going to allow it to unlock it. If it's less than that, it's not going to unlock it. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just setting it in such a way that I'll be able to use that to unlock. I already have it, so I'll delete this one. And then we are saying write the variable score. So we are going to write our score. If you don't know how to do that, go into, click on add an action, go into your storage and then write a value. So we are going to write going to write our score in high score. Sorry, let me check again. Okay, so the high score and then the storage name is data. And then we are going to write our scene variable, which is score, into our high score. So do the same for your game. So it's going to check a score greater than or equal to our total score, which I showed you, and it was 100. So it's going to check if our score is also 100 or is greater than 100. If it's greater than or equal to 100, we're going to write that score in our high score data. And that's what this particular event means. The same thing is going to happen with this one, but here the score total is, instead of 100, is 1000. So if your score is greater than or equal to 1000, then we are saying write it in high score 1 and then data 1. So do the same thing for the next one, and then you have it, depending on how many characters you have or unlocked bunnies or unlocked players you are going to be using in your game. Just do the same thing, continue with it. If this is data 1 and this is high score 1, the next one is going to be high score 2, the next one is going to be high score 3, and then you'll be changing the total score, which is a variable, a scene variable. We'll be changing them if it's 100, 100, if it's 1000, 1000, if it's 3000, 3000, 4000, 4000. So you are going to continue like that depending on how many characters you have in your game. So okay, so with that, we are going to go back to player selection, and then I'll scroll upwards. Okay, so right here we are going to check if our high score exists in our storage data. So go ahead and then add storage. So we are going to check the existence of a group storage. We are going to say our storage data is, storage name is data, the group is high score. And then click on OK. So the same thing over here. Do our high score exist in our data? If it does exist in our data, we are saying she sets the animation of locked and unlocked to unlock. So I'm talking about this lock over here. It's going to unlock it. And once it's set to unlock, just like in my previous video, once it's set to unlock, our event over here is going to pick it. Okay, so bunny 2 is unlocked. So once it's set to unlock, you'll see the padlock has unlocked, and once I click on it, it's going to send me straight away into my game, so I can use that particular player to play my game. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any comments, leave it below. If you want help with anything that has to do with your Gdevelop project, go ahead and ask. And don't forget to click on the like button and then subscribe.